guys, what's up, it's Alex. I am in beautiful Istanbul today. As I'm making a talk for a brand event here in Istanbul, it's called Brand Week. It's gonna be super fun. So you know, I just want to eat my way throughout the city. So I thought, why don't we make a little walk around the city and also do some good shopping, food shopping that goes without saying. If you want to discover the city, you can do a lot worse than going on the Asian side. Like, there's this small neighborhood called Kadikoy. Seems to be like the real deal, if you know what I mean. I don't know why I'm talking like a mafia guy. Sounds like a real deal. I think this is Kadıköy. Okay, so basically I just arrived in Kadıköy. I got some food, by the way. This is called a börek. It's like super thin filo pastry filled up with spinach and probably cheese. So I'm looking for a few things. I'm looking for a bakery. I'm looking for pickles because I know they are great around here. I'm looking for cheese and I'm looking for meat. And that sounds like a plan. So Firin here is like a bakery. You don't want to go to the chain, you want to go to the small store. Here, like in many countries, in fact, the breakfast is more or less savory stuff. Mainly cheese, I would say, and then that sesame bread. And also the bread was quite fluffy, the sesame flavor is quite intense. I think my favorite combination is sesame and parsley. The name of the place was Beyaz Firin Kadıköy. Beyaz being the real name, Firin meaning bakery, and Kadıköy is just the neighborhood. I am now an expert in Turkish. So you know I'm not a big fan of coffee, but I'm a big fan of tea. And in Turkey you have to understand that there is tea everywhere. The tea looks red, but it's a black tea. It's quite soft. Usually they don't add any sugar or any milk to it. It's a good tea. And it's called chai.
1, 3, 0.
Island. Yeah, island.
Good.
So next there was this place called Oskan. They just bring the pickle game to the next level. They pickle everything, like melon, watermelon, eggplants, onions, whole garlic head, bell peppers, like every little thing you think you can't pickle, they do it. So I bought a few things I could recognize, but honestly, most of the things, I'm not sure exactly what they are. They must be good. I don't see why they wouldn't be good. Good chance de fou. So this is Emir. Maybe you can tell them what you do.
I'm a coppersmith and silversmith as well.
He makes amazing copperware, like cookingware, like super premium stuff for the chef and for the passionate cook.
We manufacture professional stuff, like very thick, you know, but entirely by hand. And our product is used in 47 different countries around the world. Brennus soy, you gotta know it.
Okay, so yeah. Okay, so which way now?
Pastırma.
Pastırma.
It means basically compressed meat. So now I'm gonna take you to one of the most famous charcuterie of Istanbul.
Charcuterie, yes. That speaks to my heart.
They have cold mezes, come with me. Exactly, cured dry aged meat.
All spices. All the spices.
You feel it.
Cumin.
You feel it.
So the spices. Super good.
So the Kadıköy Bazaar is one of the best places for food shopping in Istanbul. Many restaurants actually basically provide their customers from here.
Oh wow. So just to give you a little update, the restaurant is not open yet.
Yes.
And yet we are eating inside. So this is like mussel rice.
It's a mussel dolma.
I'm sure it tastes way better than it looks.
It's very good. This is what we have when we're drunk.
Oh la la! Oh la la! Spices is sweet.
Exactly. Cinnamon.
Cinnamon.
Yes.
Midya dolma.
Stuffed mussel.
Stuffed mussel. Who would have thought? I feel stupid for having only like one luggage with me. I should have brought like 20 luggage. Like one for every food, like one for the pickles, one for the meat, one for the cheese.
Voilà, le lokum.
Lokum. It's funny because in English they call this Turkish delight.
The Western world got it from the Turkish Empire. So that's why it's gonna be called Turkish delight. The best spots in all of Istanbul.
Come this way. Oh, did you see the boat there, by the way?
Another Emir, thank you so much, man, for the address.
You are very welcome, au plaisir.
This is not a very safe setup, but I like this. Okay, so I am now back in the hotel. I'm about to leave for the speak I have this afternoon. I was so happy to see Istanbul again, and I think the food is just amazing, mind-blowing. So many flavors, so many smells. I know I'm just scratching the surface right here, but don't worry, because I will be reviewing those beautiful foods thoroughly in a dedicated episode. Yes. A food hall. If you like this type of video where I explore a city and I try to showcase something I particularly like, then please give this video a big thumbs up and share that all over your social media. You know how it works, just spread it like butter. If you think I totally missed a specific part of the city, please let me know in the comments. So I guess this is a small break during the ramen addiction series, but as always, feel free to subscribe to this channel for more food videos. You know, it's not always about cooking, it's always about the food, the culture, the social aspect of all this, okay? Take care, bye bye, salut!